We've been using SNOMED CT since 2013. SNOMED CT was a relatively easy choice. It came with fairly good recommendations from other users. It also had an emergency department reference set, which was particularly appealing. And as a result of that, we were able to get our hands on that ref set and have a good look at it prior to implementing. And that had certain advantages. We could see straight away that the terms that were covered off were in fact very appropriate for use in our emergency department. And it was a natural fit with the types of patients and the diagnoses that we were making.
SNOMED allows me to use my clinical judgment as freely as I had before it existed. It's a coding system that sits in the background.
The only way to capture a presenting complaint is going to be to use the SNOMED ref set. And then all diagnoses that we're capturing that are done on completion of the patient journey in the emergency department, at the point that we know the diagnosis, that's getting converted over to the presenting complaint to a SNOMED diagnostic code.
This is really just scratching the surface of the use of SNOMED. It's intuitive, it has an intelligence behind it, and it's real advantages that people can come to the emergency, clinicians who are new to the emergency department can sit in front of the screen and carry on as usual.
So we're capturing every single diagnosis that is made from our patient population entering the emergency departments, and that's all 100% SNOMED coded.
We've been finding using SNOMED 3D at a glance very useful for us. It's a lot more precise than probably what we used to do before, which was using a whiteboard system and waiting for the pre-printed charts to come out. So by able to have those fields populated by SNOMED and having the correct terminology there, it's been big advances for the department, I think. Often you just need to type in three or four letters and then it will come up with a list.
In GP records, the clinical terminology we use, which is the read code, which will be superseded by SNOMED, we use it for coding all the patient diagnoses, especially the major ones like heart disease and asthma, chronic obstructive pulmonary disease. And we use it, we have to use it for ACC forms because ACC requests that.
The read codes that come with ACC are fairly limited in their ability to fully describe the illness, the injuries that our patients sustain. SNOMED is far more precise, and so we often have problems translating our diagnosis into an acceptable read code that can capture that accurately.
Read is no longer supported. So the main problem with read is that we no longer have codes that we need for modern medicine. So coronary angioplasty with a stent is not included in read.
What we've done to enable clinicians to maximise the ability to find diagnoses that they're after is to put some smart technology into part of our information system that allows clinicians to search for the term that they are looking for very precisely. And to do this, really, it takes a minimal keystroke. I've got nothing but a high recommendation for swapping over to SNOMED. In terms of the ability to find the diagnosis that you're looking for, SNOMED, I think, is unparalleled. It is very, very easy to choose the appropriate term. It gets away from using woolly terms that really don't describe what you're seeing, and we've found it to be universally excellent.
It's part of if they want to type in atrial fibrillation as a diagnosis, the SNOMED terminology term pops up. It's easy to use. It's probably quicker than typing atrial fibrillation is to put in AF, click on the clinical terminology. So that gives them power to do things quickly. It gives them power to audit what they do.
For instance, the number of people presenting with headache and then with a diagnosis matching it up to see how many have migraines, how many have subarachnoid hemorrhages, and how many maybe it's just a simple headache. So it'll end up being the information that we have. We can use it a lot more for audit purposes, for research, you know, and maybe implementing some new pathways and things that we need.
National Patient Flow, which captures the patient journey, I think is a fantastic process that's being run that will be of huge benefit to patients, tracking them through the system and actually picking up the ability to find patients who are not running smoothly through the system. And clinical terminology is a way of tagging the patient's diagnosis, any extra problems.
The data that is coming out at the end of the day is also very, very easily understood and is very easy to compile and to dice in an appropriate way so that we can actually get really good information, not just data, from the metrics that we're actually collecting.
It will enable us to produce decision support based around clinical terminology. It's an international language, which means that we are able to do a tremendous amount of research.
St John's have incorporated SNOMED into their systems. The New Zealand formulary is using SNOMED-based codes.
In terms of future improvements, one of the biggest areas is actually going to be liaising with St John Ambulance Service. And we're hoping to see their SNOMED code, which they are now using, pre-populate our own ED information system so that we're actually all talking the same language.
It really has just made life so much easier. It's quick, it's simple to use, it finds the right terminology.
Overall very positive. Nobody seems to have negative experiences with it. It's a seamless system.
Speed up processes and make them a lot more efficient, and also give the patient a more accurate patient record, because the right data would be collected and it would be coded correctly, and that's something that could be carried with the patient wherever they go.
So it's about a partnership and an evolution, and I think it's a really exciting time. I think there'll be huge power for the clinicians and they'll get a lot of benefit from using it.